デンマークの大会で優勝することができてとても嬉しいです。
Denmark Open, we have been having a lot of good memories. So again, we could win this time. This is very great. We are very happy.
Thank you, both of you.
So our first final completed, and the Olympic champions add the Denmark Open to their list of achievements, having twice previously lost in the final here. Finally, they win the title. Next up is men's singles and a first ever Super Series tournament final for the left-handed Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk of Thailand. He's up against Song Wan Ho, who of course reached the final here 2 years ago. And for Song Wan Ho, he's in his second consecutive Super Series tournament final, having reached the final in Seoul, his home event. Then it's home interest in the mixed doubles with the three-time former champions, Jochen Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen. They're up against a young Chinese pair who have been in great form, Sheng Shiwei and Cheng Ching Cheng, in their fourth consecutive Super Series tournament final. Then it will be men's doubles and Isara and Puang Puapet of Thailand up against the Olympic silver medalists Govi Shem and Tan Wee Kyung. Neither of those men's doubles pairs have ever won a Super Series title as a pair, so one of them is going to make history today. Then we finish with women's singles and Akane Yamaguchi going for back-to-back titles, having won in Korea the last of the Super Series prior to this Denmark Open. She's up against Tai Su Ying of Chinese Taipei, who's in her third premier Super Series final of the year. So plenty more action to come, but with the men's singles up next, a chance for us to look at the Destination Dubai Super Series standings at the moment. And I can tell you that Song Wan Ho, whether he wins or loses today's final, will go up two places. From number three, he will be the new number one on that ranking list. Lee Chong Wei, having lost in the quarterfinal here, will actually go up two places to number three. So there will be some movement, there's no doubt about that. Jano Jorgensen, of course, will be pushed down. He'll go down a couple of places to number four. As far as the men's singles draw is concerned, well, the big surprise was, of course, the two-time former champion, Lee Chong Wei, who lost at quarterfinal stage on his 34th birthday. At quarterfinal stage, as though there were seven different nations involved, there was only two seeds involved. And of course, one of those seeds, Lee Chong Wei, was beaten on quarterfinal stage, but the other seeded player is in today's final. He came through an all Korean semi-final, which was a repeat of the Korean Super Series semi-final. So what an occasion for the left-hander from Thailand, Saensomboonsuk, in his first ever Super Series tournament final here today. Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk, unseeded, up against the number six seed, Song Wan Ho from Korea.
Now for the men's single final. Please welcome, from Thailand, Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk.
Oh, that's a lovely touch. Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk carrying a picture of His Late Majesty King Bhumibol Adulyadej, the whole of Thailand in mourning at the loss of the king.
First ever Super Series Premier Final. someone who has previously reached the final here back in 2014 and is now back looking for the win.
Well, one of these two players will make history today because no Korean has ever won the men's singles title here at the Denmark Open. And no Thai player has ever won any title here at the Korean Open in any discipline. So one of them will create history. In fact, for Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk, he's only the second ever player from Thailand to contest a men's singles Super Series tournament final. First player since Boonsak Ponsana was beaten in the final of the Singapore Super Series 3 years ago. It's always nice when we have a final where we know that history will be created. One of these two will rewrite the record books. The left-handed Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk turned 26 10 days ago, 18 in the world ranking at the moment, but he did spend 2 weeks at the end of October 3 years ago as world number 9. So he's been a top 10 player. He's down one place in the Super Series standings at 26 at the moment. He was a semi-finalist here in 2013, but this is first ever Super Series tournament final. He's on a great run of results, not just here, but he's on a 10-match winning streak, because prior to coming here, he won the Thailand Grand Prix Gold, his first ever Grand Prix Gold title and his fourth Grand Prix Gold tournament final. Well, he was taken the full distance from Sai Pranith in the very first round, and then against the qualifier, Anders Antonsen of Denmark. What a huge talent he is. And then in the semi-final yesterday, beat Brice Lavadaise, who was competing in his first ever Super Series semi-final. And of course, it was Brice Lavadaise who beat the two-time former champion and current world number one, Lee Chong Wei. So as far as Son Wan-ho is concerned, he's 28 years of age from Changwon. And this is his third final this year and third Super Series tournament final this year, because he was beaten in the final of the Singapore Super Series and then the final of his home event, the Korean Super Series, lost out to Chiao Bin in 3 games. Well, he had to beat the winner of the Australian Open in the first round, Hans Christian Vietinghus, and then the former finalist here, Mark Zwiebler. Zwiebler had been in the final in 2009. Then he was stretched the full distance by the gold medalist from the Youth Olympic Games, Shi Yuqi. And then in the semi-final, the former world number one, another Korean player, the left-handed Lee Hyun Il. So for Son Wan-ho, today's final, he will be playing against a third left-hander in this tournament, because Mark Zwiebler was the other left-hander, not only his semi-final opponent. Well, this will be the third meeting between these two players, and Son Wan-ho has won both of the previous meetings. The last time they met was in the first round of the Singapore Super Series. It was 2 straight games in just 46 minutes, and Son Wan-ho, as I've already said, went on to reach the final of that Singapore Super Series. Our umpire for this one, Christian Johannesson of Denmark, Eric Kurtz, also from Denmark, will be the service judge.
Ladies and gentlemen, on my right, Son Wan-ho, Korea. On my left, Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk, Thailand. Son Wan-ho to serve. La ball, play.
So the men's singles final. Son Wanho beaten by Chen Long 2 years ago in the final here. Well, I had a question mark, I suppose, in my mind about how this man, playing in his first ever Super Series tournament final, how he would cope with the nerves and the occasion. But that was a nice opening rally because that will have settled the nerves. We haven't had a left-handed winner of this Denmark Open since 2007, when in Dan. Yeah.
One, oh.
And since we've had the Super Series, there has never been an unseeded player who's won this men's singles title. But of course, we have had three unseeded players win Super Series titles this year, haven't we? In Singapore, it was the qualifier, Sonny Dwi Kunchoro. Only the second time in Super Series history that a qualifier has won a men's singles title. And then Hans Christian Vittinghus, unseeded, won the Australian Open. And the last Super Series prior to this, the Korean Open, Chiao Bin won, unseeded. Good follow up.
Great smash here by Saensomboonsuk. He's not afraid to hit the cross smash to his own backhand side, willing to invest the long run. Very important, I think, that he gets variation to his attack. As someone who is very skillful in his defense.
Well, Son Wanho's previous two finals this year at Super Series events, the Singapore Open and then the Korean Open, were the two occasions, two of the three occasions, where he's lost to unseeded players. Just wide. Good judgment. And I would have said prior to both of his previous finals this year, Steen, I would have said he was overwhelming favourite, but having seen the fact that having been favourite, he's not necessarily struggled, because I think his opponents played very well and deserved to win, but there is a question mark in my mind.
Yeah. I would also have him as the favourite here, but we saw that Saensomboonsuk coming in with this picture in his hand. It's not always that it has an impact, that you have some special motivation, but I definitely wouldn't rule it out.
Yeah.
Five, 4.
I think he's aspired a number of times, Sonnenhall, to sort of make his mark within the top five in men's singles. Capable of playing really, really good, and was a big factor in the Danish Thomas Cup win, in my opinion, because he beat Chen Long, and Korea went on to win their team match against China, which was, in my opinion, helpful for Denmark. But he hasn't really, as you say, he hasn't been able to get it done in the finals.
Oh my goodness.
So the Solvan.
Oh dear. Hey. Stretching out, is he okay? I certainly hope he is. No, and it's interesting because not only that victory against Chen Long in the Thomas Cup campaign, but he was also instrumental in Korea's gold medal in the men's team competition
Asian
of the
Games.
Asian Games.
Yeah. Again. Where he also beat Chen Long.
Exactly. And in fact, at the Olympic Games earlier this summer, he was the only player to take Chen Long to three games.
Yeah. A bit unlucky for him to be facing Chen Long at such an early stage in the tournament. So
yeah.
We don't really know what could he have done had he been in the middle of the draw instead of...
Good
facing
point.
The top seed, or was it the top seed or the second seed?
Second seed.
Second seed, yeah. Definitely not one of the players that you'd wish to play at the Olympics because of his great touch. Great defensive skills. There's always a lot of nerves in the Olympics, and if you have the ability to play a good defense, then you come a long way. Great variation.
Straight points for the left-hander. That's a good lift. Oh, yes. Oh. Nicely done.
That is over. Seven, eight.
Oh, well taken. It's utterly amazing what confidence can do for an athlete. You know, prior to even the Thailand Grand Prix gold, when Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk won his first Grand Prix gold title, he perhaps wouldn't have said he was favourite going into his home event. And then coming here at Super level and a Premier Super Series at that. And suddenly, you know, I mean, this is the remarkable thing about sport, isn't it? Because it shows that skill-wise, he's always been pushing top 10 players, but suddenly with the confidence as well, here he is in a final.
And the matches in the bag, I mean, playing 10 matches, you don't suddenly get confused when you've got 20 and say, oh, I'm about to win this. No, it's normal. I've won nine.
Yeah.
11, 7, interval.
Oh, this is amazing start.
Service. Every turn service. Move first. Chut, service. Nah, you're too slow. Okay? Sometimes not just is okay. Sometimes get here and
sometimes just there. You can see the Korean coaches with Son Wan-ho.
Remember, just five or six. Rally low, yeah? Okay.
Oh, Hoon-wei. And Agus Dwi Santoso, who is originally from Indonesia. And what a contrast to the man from Thailand, because he doesn't even have a coach with him. He's an independent player. And therefore, no coach. You'll have to serve again. Son Wan-ho, not ready.
Independent clubs and badminton schools appearing not only in Asia but also in Europe. But we haven't seen that many reach this level. Marcus Kido and Hendra Sechaman shortly after the Olympic win.
Mm.
And also Sony Kunkoro.
Yeah.
Coached by his wife. 13, that's a tough coach.
So you wouldn't like to be coached by your wife then?
I think I have second thoughts about it. I mean, what's the cut of the prize money?
Nine of the last 10 points going to the left-hander. That's incredible, isn't it?
He's looking very, very concentrated. Saensomboonsuk being very deliberate with his walk around the court, not hurrying himself at all.
Well, in fact, the umpire is. Okay, if you want to change the shuttle, that's fine, but do it right away. So already the umpire has spotted exactly what you've spotted.
No.
But he has been deliberate in between rallies and taking his time.
Service over. 8-14. I
don't know if you saw the Korean Open final.
No, I didn't see it.
Because there was a bit of a debacle in the middle of that, because this man, Son Wan-ho, decided that his red shoes were not fitting properly or not comfortable, and he didn't have any spare shoes with him. And his sponsors got some brand new shoes out of a box, were bright yellow, but he could hardly move in them, and it all took about 7 or 8 minutes, literally, to get that sorted out. Yeah, that's a good angle. Forced the short lift, haven't they?
Yeah. Well, that's a rookie mistake, not having a spare pair of shoes. 14.
I thought most badminton players not only had a spare kit in the kit bag that they bring down to the stadium, I always used to have a spare pair of shoes in my hand luggage on aeroplanes because I couldn't afford to lose your shoes.
You can't lose your shoes or your racket.
Yeah.
Everything else can be replaced, but the shoes and racket, that's highly personal.
Yeah.
Also, a number of players play with special made soles in their shoes, and if they're gone.
Special orthotics.
Yeah.
15.
So if they get lost in.
Then you're in big trouble.
Yeah, then you probably will have to withdraw.
Wide. Goodness me, it was a nice idea, wasn't it? Little hold.
11, 15.
Someone Ho's coming forward, expecting the next shot. Same thing in reply.
16,
good net shot, 11. Forcing the short lift. Certainly so far, I think that Saensomboonsuk has got the better of his opponent on the net play.
Yeah, he's been playing really well at the net. We saw that also yesterday against Anders Antonsen. No, that wasn't yesterday. That was the day before yesterday.
That was Friday.
Final.
Yeah.
That he's controlling the net and also his basic game. He's making very, very few mistakes. And I think that comes from playing these 10 competitive matches.
Mm.
Suddenly you get a better feel for where the lines are and you feel comfortable on court.
Yeah. 11. Yeah, that's a brilliant take off the top of the tape.
Thailand had a great tournament altogether here at three semi-finalists. And two finalists today.
Men's doubles as well.
12, 18.
Yep, good call. Points away from this opening game. Absolutely delightful, isn't it? Just let the shuttle drop slightly and then just turn the racket head to play that perfect net shot.
Good shot.
Very good shot. And with it comes game point opportunities.
20, game point 13.
It is a terrific angle, isn't it?
And very steep.
Yeah.
Well placed and steep smash.
Yeah, opening game. Unseeded Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk. 21-13 confirms the umpire. Just 20 minutes of play. Well, we're about to see another upset in the Super Series men's singles final.
Okay, more confident. Yeah, more confident. Something. And then too slow.
Earlier this week, with the two Danish men singles players, Vitting Hus and Victor Axelsen, and they were sort of trying to predict the winners of all five categories. I think they both had the women's doubles correct, but men's singles, Victor Axelsen was believing in himself, and of course that didn't go so well, and I think Vitting Hus took the obvious choice of selecting Lee Chong Wei, so none of them had this men's singles final.
Just shows the strength and depth, doesn't it, across the discipline. You know, seven different, well, players from seven different countries in quarterfinal stage, yeah. And you know, seeded players, it's not unusual to see them beaten in the first or second round because every match is so tough.
And we've seen it with the men's doubles as well, where, I mean, later today we're going to see Go Wee Shem and Tan Wee Kyung, and in my opinion, they've played three finals already in this tournament.
Yeah, yeah.
This week, I mean, three really, really good matches so far.
Brilliant. Finds the line.
Yeah. One love.
Third nine shots.
Is that the longest so far?
I'm not sure. I was just checking it because I think maybe that's the solution for Son Wan-ho. To play longer rallies, but it's difficult when Saensomboonsuk is playing with this patience and still can go in when the chances occur and hit winners like we saw him do in the first rally. So in many ways, with the way his game has developed in the last two tournaments. Saensomboonsuk, he's probably not unsatisfied playing Son Wan-ho because Son's defense is really, really great, but his attack is perhaps not as dangerous. And it's the defensive patient style that he's known for, and that means that Saensomboonsuk gets to play his game, gets to wait for the opportunity. It's not like if he plays a little bit too passive that Son is going to be a real threat to him in the defense. that way the sun is attacking Saensomboonsuk. As long as he can score from his offense, Saensomboonsuk, there's a bigger and bigger chance that Sun sort of is panicking and say, hey, I got to do something because my defense is clearly not working against this guy.
Yeah.
And then there could be a lot of mistakes.
Of course, the Korean has won Super Series titles in the past. He's won two, the 2012 India Super Series and then the 2014 Hong Kong. And sometimes, you know, I see with players, you see the Japanese men's doubles pair, Hawakawa and Endo, and they've played in six Super Series tournament finals, never won one. You've got the Dane, Victor Axelsen, he's played in six Super Series tournament finals, never won one. Targo, I think, played five or six, was it?
Didn't win one.
And it becomes a psychological block. So it shouldn't be a psychological block for someone home.
He's already got some.
He's already got two.
Yeah. And exactly what I was referring to when I said he's aspired to get into, to break into being a regular top five player, but hasn't been able to follow up on it.
No. Yeah, and even so, he's been ranked as high as four. He's not been a regular semi-finalist and finalist at these major tournaments.
He's suddenly disappeared and been first, second round casualty.
Yeah.
Probably doing military service at some point as well.
Yeah.
I seem to recall.
Yes, it was straight after the London Olympic Games. In fact, he did 6 months of military duty and then had shin splints, so he was actually out for 9 months.
That's of course a setback.
But you look at his results from last year, certainly in Super Series tournaments. He played 11 of the 12 tournaments, only one semi-final and one quarter-final. Seonwon-ho. So that emphasizes your point that, you know, though he on his day can beat anybody in the world,
he's had difficulties getting it all together in 1 week.
Yeah.
He's playing well, Saensomboonsuk.
6-3.
So far, keeping it together in a good way. Balance in the rallies never really opens the court for Sun.
7.
And it's amazing because suddenly the defense that has seemed so solid seems really vulnerable.
Is that because perhaps that little bit of panic is setting in?
Perhaps. I mean, the variation of Saensomboonsuk and the importance of the match. It's quite an amount of prize money for the winner of this men's single. I feel he has to do something, Saensomboonsuk, to sort of create uncertainty on the Thailand side of the court, attack a little bit more, put some deceptions into his game, get his defense going, get a rally where he plays fantastic defense and sort of reads Saensomboonsuk. excellent, fantastic.
Yeah.
We get a replay here. Look at the quick release of his bracket there. Not a whole lot of arm used, only a flick of the racket.
Yeah, the racket head, because there was no follow through afterwards
either. No follow through, and that makes it really, really steep.
Yeah, I like that. He's played the net so well that now these little hold and flicks become very effective.
They do. And he can play the net from a little bit of a distance, and that's very valuable.
He's playing amazing badminton at the moment, isn't he?
He is, and right now Son has to hope that he gets a little bit tense. But I mean, if you have a lead of 10 or 11-4, there's little chance that you get tense. He's got to come closer,
yeah,
the Korean player, in order to create some tension on his with his opponent. And look how few times Saensomboonsuk plays from below the tape. It's very rarely.
Yeah.
He plays from around the tape in the net game and so on, but very rarely in the defense.
Oh, indecision. Time left the shuttle, and it was the correct decision, and he has a 6-point advantage here in the second game, having already taken the first.
For me, yeah, that's free. Yeah, it's relaxed, it's okay. Yeah, just here and free. Yes, just enjoy your game, something but fight is something. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah.
That was interesting. Relax, play free, but fight
and enjoy your game.
Mm.
Well, it's so easy to say that. It's so difficult to do it.
Mm. But doesn't that signal that the coaches realize that he's very nervous?
Yeah.
And there's a lot of tension.
It does.
Yeah.
But it's just I have a hard time see
11,
how it can help, because, I mean,
play.
Right now he can't cope with the attack coming from Saensomboonsuk. So what could he do? Attack, perhaps. But yeah, that's also easier said than done, because
yeah.
6-11.
Saensomboonsuk has played well. But I think perhaps the way to see it is that, you're not going to be relaxed in this match, but you're going to play anyway.
Yeah.
You're going to have to play as good as possible with the discomfort of the nerves and so on from playing a Premier Series final.
Yeah.
7-11.
Yeah, he's never won a Premier Super Series. And here 2 years ago was the only time prior to this he's been in a Premier Super Series tournament final.
It was not a good shot. He was about to get something going, winning the first 12, 2 points after the interval. Seven. It's interesting that the Indonesian coach was speaking English, because then we must assume that Sun's English is quite good.
Yeah.
We rarely hear the Korean players speak English.
What a good lift from there. It's wide.
Yeah.
Yes, and you're absolutely right. I mean, and the 13, I am told that the recently retired Lee Yongdae speaks quite good English as well, but we rarely hear it.
Yeah. Good shot. Good shot.
Service over.
Good judgment.
Yeah, and well played at the net. The thing is, when you get nervous or tense to someone, you have a tendency to fall back to your preferred style of play. That means that Sun probably will be more likely to play defensive shots and just get it away from the front court and so on, and should Saensomboonsuk, what a great smash here. Should he be a little tensed, he would be more likely to fire smashes away all the time and not build up the way he's been building up here.
Well, of course, with neither of these players having won a Super Series title this year, we're guaranteed a seventh different player winning the men's singles title in the ninth Super Series of the year. That's a nice net shot. Oh, that's an even better drop shot. Crikey. That's what you call perfection. Look at this. Sat on the top of the tape, then decided to go over. Oh, my goodness.
Excellent play also by Sun.
Yeah.
11-14.
The way I see it, he's risking everything in trying to take over the control of the net, and I think that's a good plan. Got to get Saensomboonsuk to lift to him.
Oh, well taken.
And this is one of the situations where it's obvious that he's not a natural net player or a natural attacking player. He would have been up and pouncing on the shot from Saensomboonsuk. Oh, well, was he calling for something there, or was it white?
Oh, that is wide. We haven't had a challenge actually so far in this match, have we?
No.
No, we can't actually see this line from where we're sitting, but yeah, definitely wide.
That was wide, yeah.
Great control at the net, wasn't it?
Oi. Mm.
There's a couple of times he's hesitated at the back, unsure of his spatial awareness, perhaps, or... Look, he's going to leave it, and then sort of thinks, oh, I better try and play that, and completely mistimed it. He's done well, hasn't he? Closed down this deficit, a 6-point deficit at the game interval. No, only 1 point in it. And you're right, Steen, it's all about the net play.
That was a really, really good shot, the last one there.
15-4.
Good job by Saensomboonsuk to even get the first back.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you said it needed to be closer to make Saensomboonsuk a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
And I think I'm seeing a little bit of tension in him right now.
I think so too. But it's also due to someone who being brave and changing his style a little bit.
7 straight points.
Oh.
Oh. Well, this is becoming a very, very intriguing battle for supremacy at the front of the court. Is well taken. 16-all. Of course, I just gave you duff information. It was 6 of the last 7 points that he'd won.
It was 14-9.
Yeah.
Yeah. Didn't really get the length on that lift. Son-Wan-Ho.
Look where he's landing, the left-hander, inside the double service line. Where the feet land, always an indication of the length of the opponent's shot.
He's got to continue challenging Son-Wan-Ho. That's what got him back into this match.
Oh, that's terrific. What an accurate smash. Yeah. That's perfect. I like that. Wasn't going full power, more on balance.
17-18.
Terrific. How good was that? Once again, it wasn't full power, was it?
No.
Terrific angle. So 18 all. Nerves are going to play a part in this.
No.
He'd got the lift that he wanted.
He's got his own little fan group here and four or five persons. Saensomboonsuk.
Two tantalizing points away from a first ever Super Series title.
Almost tripping.
Yeah. Well, I hope that celebration isn't premature.
Yeah.
One more point needed.
20, match point 18.
On the verge of victory. Two match point opportunities for Saensomboonsuk. Challenge. I think that's out of hope more than anything else. First challenge of the match.
It could win him.
It could win him.
Premier Series.
Oh, it looks up to the giant screen. Here we go. What does Hawkeye say?
Yeah. In.
In.
And a very good deception by Son-Wan-Ho.
Yeah.
He also had it on the 18 all, but where he missed the smash due to the fight of Saensomboonsuk.
Yeah, I think in fairness, he also broke a string of his racket, didn't he, at 18 all with that smash. So, one match point has come and gone.
Oh,
goodness.
Good shot.
Didn't have the courage to go for the kill. And now it's 20 all, two match points saved from someone. Oh, 20 all, and we will require extra points until there's a clear 2-point winning margin.
I can't help think of that celebration.
I know.
He got to 2018. I mean,
that's why I said I hope it isn't premature, because I had exactly the same feeling.
Sometimes you signal unconsciously to your brain and your body that it's over. Mm. Just not.
Brilliant. Well, again, raises his arms in celebration, but he still needs another point.
But it was important for him to win this one. It was really, really important.
Will it be third time lucky? Third match point opportunity. Courage. Almost landed in.
Great control.
Yeah.
There must be a lot of adrenaline in his body right now. It would have been so easy to give it a little bit too much.
Yeah. Unbelievable. Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk in his first ever Super Series tournament final wins the title here at one of the five premiers. What a performance. What a couple of tournaments he's had. It was only a couple of weeks ago that he won his first ever Grand Prix gold title, and he did that on home soil. He's come to Denmark. He's not only reached his first ever Super Series tournament final, he leaves as champion. Two straight games, 21-13, 23-21, in 55 minutes of play, one on his fourth match point opportunity. This, the moment of victory, a moment that he will savor forever.
The runner-up from Korea, Seongwon Ho.
His third Super Series tournament final of the year, and the third time he has to settle for second best.
Yonex Denmark Open, presented by Lalisa, with the final score of 21-13, 23-21 from Thailand. Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk.
Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk, a picture of His Late Majesty King Bhumibol Adulyadej. Well, it's only his fifth ever title. But what a couple of weeks. What an advancement for Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk. But also, Steen, I think it's probably a wonderful thing for the sport of badminton and the men's singles that, you know, a player can come to a premier Super Series and win the title. Nobody would have backed him, I don't think, a month ago for winning here.
No, I was thinking about what would he, had there been odds on the winner, what would his odds have been ahead of this tournament?
Yeah.
The local gifts and flowers presented by Brian Skov Nielsen, Deputy Mayor, Department of Employment and Social Services. Give a warm round of applause for the finals.
Tanongsak, congratulations. This is your first Super Series title. How does it feel?
Yeah, I feel really happy. Just, this is my first champion in Super Series. Yeah.
Lots of people are surprised to see you as the winner of Denmark Open. Are you surprised yourself?
Yes, very surprised because this match I play really well. Then I made champion for my king. Yeah.
Thank you. Congratulations.
So what a sensation, Tanongsak Saensomboonsuk winning the Premier Super Series title here at the Yonex Denmark Open, his first ever Super Series tournament final, beating Sonwan Ho of Korea. Well, next up, again, history could be made because the three-time former champions, Jochen Fischer-Nielsen and Christina Pedersen, trying to become only the second pair in Super Series history to win the mixed doubles title.